Welcome to the FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. Fairy Pufflet and the Gnomes. Chapter 1. The Gnomes' Trickery. One moonlit night, in the heart of an emerald forest, Pufflet the fairy was resting in her cozy glade, nestled within the petals of a moonflower. The gentle breeze rustled through the trees, carrying the delicate scent of wildflowers and the soft chirping of crickets. Pufflet had always found solace in her glade, a sanctuary where she could bask in the glow of moonbeams and recharge her magic. As she drifted off into a peaceful slumber, she was unaware of the mischievous eyes that watched from the shadows. Among the twisted roots and dense underbrush, a band of gnomes, small and nimble, observed the fairy with a mix of excitement and urgency. They were cloaked in dark robes, their faces obscured by the hoods, only their twinkling lanterns casting eerie shadows on the forest floor. They communicated in hushed whispers and subtle gestures, each movement purposeful as they planned their daring abduction. Their leader, a gnome named Thistletoe, believed that Pufflet's fairy magic was the answer to their problems. Their forest home was threatened by forces beyond their control, and they were convinced that Pufflet could protect them if only they could harness her powers. With a nod from Thistletoe, the gnomes sprang into action. They formed a circle around the moonflower, their lanterns illuminating the petals with an otherworldly glow. Thistletoe stepped forward and began to chant in the ancient gnomish tongue, invoking a spell that would bind Pufflet in a deep sleep. The fairy stirred slightly as the magic took hold, and her wings shimmered with a faint, iridescent light before becoming still. With Pufflet securely under their spell, the gnomes gently lifted her from the flower and placed her in a small, ornate cage made of willow branches and silver threads. They worked quickly, for the moon was beginning to dip below the horizon, and they needed to be far away by dawn. Carrying their precious cargo, the gnomes slipped into the labyrinth of hidden forest paths that led to their secret realm. The journey through the winding paths was long and treacherous. The forest was dense and shrouded in mist, with branches that clawed at the gnomes' cloaks and roots that threatened to trip them. The gnomes were undeterred, however, driven by their belief in Pufflet's power and their desperate need for her help. Their lanterns bobbed like will-o'-the-wisps, leading them deeper into the forest and away from the glade where Pufflet had found peace. Hours passed before they finally reached the threshold of their realm. It was a hidden place, surrounded by a barrier of twisted roots and thorny vines. Thistletoe raised his lantern high and spoke an incantation, causing the roots to part and reveal a narrow entrance. One by one, the gnomes slipped through, cradling Pufflet's cage as if it were a priceless treasure. Inside, Pufflet slowly awakened to find herself in a land unlike any she had ever seen. The sky was a swirling mass of indigo and violet, illuminated by stars that seemed impossibly close. whispering woods surrounded her, their branches bending and swaying as if they were listening to every sound. Ancient ruins dotted the landscape, half buried in moss and ivy, their once proud arches crumbling under the weight of time. Pufflet realized she was far from home, and a pang of fear clutched her heart. She reached out to touch the cage's delicate silver threads, feeling their cold surface under her fingers. She fluttered her wings, testing her strength, but the cage held firm. Undeterred by the gnome's trickery, Pufflet vowed to find her way back to her glade and her friends. The gnomes, however, had other plans. They intended to keep her in their care, believing that her fairy magic could help protect their kind from the impending danger that loomed over their enchanted forest home. They watched her with wary eyes, torn between admiration for her beauty and fear of her powers. Thistletoe approached the cage, his lantern casting long shadows across the moss-covered ground. "Pufflet the fairy," he began in a soft voice. "We have brought you here, not out of malice, but necessity. Our forest home is in peril, and we believe your magic is our only hope." Pufflet listened quietly, her gaze unwavering as she met Thistletoe's eyes. Though her wings were bound and her powers limited, she knew that her journey was only just beginning. She would not yield to fear or despair, for she had a glimmer of hope that her resourcefulness and courage would guide her through the trials ahead. Chapter 2: The Enchanted Journey. Determined to escape her captors, Pufflet the fairy focused on her mission with unwavering resolve. The gnomes kept her in a delicate silver cage within a labyrinth of dark tunnels, believing that their magic was strong enough to contain her. But the fairy's spirit was unbroken. One night, when the gnomes became complacent and their guards fell asleep by the dimming light of their lanterns, Pufflet saw her chance. With a subtle spell she had learned in her glade, she whispered to the silver threads that bound her, coaxing them to loosen their grip. Slowly and silently, the cage opened just wide enough for her to slip through. Once free, Pufflet darted through the tunnels, her wings shimmering in the moonlight that seeped through the cracks in the walls. She emerged into the cool night air and looked around to get her bearings. In the distance, she saw the dense canopy of the Whispering Woods, and she flew toward it, hoping to find safety among its twisted branches. The forest was dimly lit, the moon barely visible through the thick mist that curled around the gnarled trees. Pufflet knew she needed allies if she was to navigate this mysterious land and find her way home. She fluttered from branch to branch, her wings leaving trails of iridescent light as she searched for signs of friendly creatures. Deep within the forest, Pufflet discovered a clearing where a gentle brook trickled over moss-covered rocks. There, she met Leaf Song, a forest sprite with emerald green wings who had lived among the trees for centuries. Leaf Song offered her shelter in the hollow of an ancient oak and shared stories of the Whispering Woods and its inhabitants. He revealed that the gnomes had long been fearful of encroaching outsiders and that their forest was threatened by a powerful sorcerer who sought to harness the magical energies of the land. With Leaf Song's guidance, Pufflet ventured beyond the forest, journeying through a series of serene villages nestled in the valleys of rolling hills. The villagers were initially wary of the fairy, But as they listened to her tale, they recognized her genuine desire to help. They spoke of swirling plains to the west, where ethereal winds carried secrets whispered by the stars. They also warned of the ancient sorcerer who lurked in a distant castle, shrouded in mist. The plains were a vast expanse of shimmering grass that rippled like waves beneath the starlit sky. Pufflet marveled at the magic in the air as the winds twisted and swirled around her, whispering of old fears and buried memories. There she met Stardust, a wise phoenix who had soared over the plains for generations. The phoenix shared stories of the gnome's hidden fears and the sorcerer's ambitions, providing Pufflet with crucial clues that helped her piece together the full story. From the plains, Pufflet journeyed to the ancient castles surrounded by blooming gardens. These structures stood tall and regal, their stone walls covered in ivy and adorned with bright flowers that filled the air with their fragrance. Each castle held secrets, and Pufflet sought out its enchanted inhabitants for advice. She listened intently to the stories of old witches and ancient fairies who had long watched over the land. In one particular castle, overgrown with morning glories and daisies, she met Ivy, a gentle enchantress with a crown of wildflowers. Ivy had lived for centuries in the castle's highest tower, observing the world below through her scrying mirror. She revealed to Pufflet that the sorcerer was driven by a desire for dominance and believed that the gnome's magic was the key to his plans. Pufflet learned that the sorcerer had manipulated the gnomes into thinking they were in grave danger, fostering their fears to push them toward desperate measures. Armed with this knowledge, Pufflet resolved to confront the gnomes and free them from their misplaced loyalty. Her journey through dark forests, soothing villages, swirling plains, and blooming castles was marked by thrilling encounters and mysterious happenings that tested her resolve at every turn. The winding paths were fraught with danger, and strange creatures lurked in the shadows, but Pufflet pressed on. Each step brought her closer to unraveling the truth and finding her way home. With newfound courage and the wisdom of the creatures she had met along the way, Pufflet was ready to confront her captors. She understood now that the gnomes were not inherently evil, but were instead blinded by their fears. Pufflet knew that this adventure would demand all her bravery and cunning. But with her allies by her side and her wings shimmering in the moonlight, she was prepared for the challenges ahead. The enchanted journey had only just begun. Chapter 3: Confrontation and Revelation. After her journey through dark forests, soothing villages, swirling plains, and blooming gardens, Pufflet the fairy finally found her way back to the gnome's hidden lair. Nestled within a labyrinth of dense roots and underbrush, it was well concealed and protected by layers of magic that warded off intruders. Guided by the knowledge she had gained on her travels, Pufflet slipped past the barriers and made her way through the dimly lit corridors. A feeling of dread descended upon her as she proceeded more into the lair. She could hear the gnomes murmuring in the distance, and the flickering flames created spooky shadows on the stone walls. She inhaled deeply before moving inside the main chamber, her wings giving off a subtle shimmer in the low light. The gnomes gasped as they recognized her. They hadn't expected the fairy to return, and looked at each other nervously as they wondered why she had come back. Thistletoe, their leader, stepped forward, his lantern casting long shadows across the room. He was taken aback by the determination in Pufflet's eyes. "You," Thistletoe stammered. "Why have you returned, Pufflet? Have you come to seek revenge?" Pufflet floated closer to the center of the room, her wings fluttering with barely restrained emotion. "I came back for answers," she said, her voice clear and unwavering. "Why did you abduct me from my home? What did you hope to achieve by stealing me away?" The gnomes shifted uneasily as they glanced at each other. Thistletoe, who had been their spokesperson throughout the ordeal, lowered his lantern and spoke softly. "We had no ill intentions toward you, Pufflet. We were afraid. Our forest is under threat from forces beyond our control. We believed your magic could save us." Pufflet furrowed her brow. "Under threat? What do you mean?" Thistletoe motioned to the other gnomes, and they began to recount their tale. The forest where they had lived for centuries was a haven of enchantment and mystery. But lately, strange occurrences had disturbed their peace. Trees withered overnight, the rivers ran dry, and the air grew thick with ominous whispers. The gnomes, deeply superstitious, believed that these signs heralded the coming of a powerful sorcerer who sought to harness the forest's magic for his own purposes. "We were desperate," Thistletoe admitted. "We thought that if we had you, Pufflet, your powers could ward off the sorcerer and keep our people safe. We didn't mean to frighten you, but we didn't know what else to do." Pufflet listened with an open heart as the gnomes spoke of their fears and the growing uncertainty that had gripped their community. She saw the anxiety in their eyes and realized that their actions were not driven by malice, but by a deep-seated desire to protect their home. "You were wrong to take me without asking," she said gently. "But I understand now that you acted out of fear. You only wanted to save your people." The gnomes nodded slowly, their faces downcast. They had seen the error of their ways and regretted their actions. Thistletoe glanced up at Pufflet, his expression hopeful. "Can you forgive us, Pufflet?" The fairy smiled kindly. "I forgive you. But you must understand that my magic alone cannot solve your problems. The sorcerer who threatens your forest is powerful, but you are not helpless against him. If you work together and seek the help of your neighbors, you can build strong alliances that will protect your home." The gnomes listened intently as Pufflet spoke of her journey and the creatures she had met along the way. She described the wisdom of the forest sprite Leaf Song, the courage of Stardust the Phoenix, and the magical prowess of Ivy, the gentle enchantress. Each of these allies had shared insights into the gnome's plight and provided valuable advice on how they could fortify their defenses. Inspired by Pufflet's words, the gnomes pledged to forge new bonds with their neighbors and protect their forest through unity and cooperation. Thistletoe offered Pufflet a seat at the head of the chamber, and the gnomes gathered around her, eager to hear her ideas. In the days that followed, the gnomes opened their doors to the fairies, sprites, and other creatures that had long been kept at a distance. They formed a council, led by Thistletoe and Pufflet, to oversee the forest's defense and ensure that no one was left vulnerable. Pufflet saw the fear that had once gripped the gnomes slowly fade as they built new friendships and worked together. She felt a sense of fulfillment knowing that she had helped them overcome their fears and realized that her journey had been worth every trial she had faced along the way. Chapter 4, A Harmonious Solution. After the confrontation with the gnomes, Pufflet understood their fears and their deep desire to protect their forest home. She was moved by their earnestness and willingness to change. Determined to help them, Pufflet set aside her grievances and offered them a solution that would not only keep them safe, but also improve their lives. With her guidance and magic, the gnomes set out to build a new village deep within the forest, where they could live in harmony. The first step was choosing a location that was both secure and welcoming. Pufflet, with her deep connection to the forest, led the gnomes through the winding paths until they reached a serene grove surrounded by towering ancient oaks and illuminated by soft beams of sunlight. This place felt magical, like a sanctuary nestled in nature's embrace. The gnomes were captivated by its beauty and decided that this grove would be their new home. Together, they began constructing their village, using materials sourced sustainably from the forest. Their nimble hands wove vines and branches into homes that blended seamlessly with the landscape. Pufflet used her magic to bless the soil, allowing fruits and vegetables to flourish around the village, providing ample food for the gnomes. She also summoned gentle springs to bubble up, providing them with fresh water. As the gnomes worked, Pufflet taught them to open their hearts and minds to the other magical creatures living nearby. She encouraged them to welcome sprites, fairies, and even woodland animals to their new village. Slowly, the gnomes overcame their isolationist mindset and began to embrace the concept of community. They forged alliances with neighboring creatures and established a network of trust and friendship that would ensure their continued safety. Leaf Song, the forest sprite, was the first to visit, bringing with him music and stories that filled the gnomes' evenings with joy. Stardust, the phoenix, flew in from the swirling plains, his bright plumage leaving trails of light that danced across the night sky. He shared his wisdom and helped strengthen their defenses. Ivy, the gentle enchantress, enchanted the village with protective spells, weaving her magic into the very fabric of their homes. Over time, the gnomes became an integral part of this larger community. They contributed their skills and knowledge, working side by side with their new friends to care for the forest. Their village became a haven where peace reigned, and the air was filled with laughter and song. In gratitude for her unwavering support, the gnomes presented Pufflet with a magical amulet. It was made from a rare gem that shimmered like the moon on a clear night, encased in a delicate filigree of silver leaves. The gnomes had infused the amulet with their own magic, making it a powerful token of protection and a symbol of the bond they had formed with Pufflet. Touched by their gesture, Pufflet accepted the amulet with tears in her eyes. She knew she would always have a home in the gnomes' village, but she also felt a longing to return to her glade. With a heartfelt farewell, she took to the sky, her wings fluttering in the golden light of dawn as she soared above the treetops. The amulet glowed softly around her neck, guiding her way back to her glade. As she landed gently among the moonflowers, she felt a deep sense of fulfillment and wisdom. Her journey had broadened her world and opened her eyes to the importance of understanding and kindness. She now knew that the bonds of friendship could overcome even the greatest fears. The tale of Pufflet and the gnomes became a beloved story that was told throughout the forest and beyond. It inspired listeners with its message of understanding, kindness, and adventure. Young sprites and fairies dreamed of exploring the world as Pufflet had done, while the gnomes' village continued to flourish as a beacon of harmony and unity. Whenever Pufflet looked at the amulet around her neck, she was reminded of the courage it took to face the unknown, the power of listening, and the joy that comes from helping others. She knew that the journey she'd undertaken was only the beginning of many more adventures to come.